Hey, good day. My name is Gunnar. I work for Salesforce on the core developer productivity group, which is responsible for the monolith. And specifically, my area is the area of developer of our core build and the IDE experience. And in the next couple of minutes, I share a little bit of the work that we did in the last year for bringing Java development support into VS Code. To give a little bit of context, we have a heavy Java source code base in our monolith, and so we have users in living in the IDEs, Eclipse and IntelliJ, and we also have a UI component in our monolith, which is the developer base using JavaScript and TypeScript mostly. So they like to spend their day in VS Code, so they kind of came to us and asked, hey, what can we do about Java development in VS Code? Good news is, it's actually pretty solid already. So there's a, you're gonna need three things, and only one of those is the ones we built. The language support itself is based off a language server that's developed by Red Hat. And then there is a debugger extension that's developed by Microsoft. And we built a Bazel Java extension that actually hooks into the language server. It's still a VS Code plugin, but it hooks into the language server. And then with that, it translates the Bazel build files into a class path so that VS Code is able to do code completion and all the nice little features of the language server. Fun fact, that language support that Red Hat built is actually a headless Eclipse. So every time you use Java in VS Code, you're using Eclipse underneath. Yeah, if you go to the website, it's the full list of features, what you can do. And literally with the Bazel extensions that we did, we got debug support working, and we got every single feature of the language support working in VS Code. So you can do the simple things like code completion, open declarations, search for references, and all these kind of things. But you can also do more, like run the unit tests, debug them right from the IDE. Now to the interesting part. There's a few things that we learned from this. Right now, it works with sample projects, small projects that we did. And we're looking into scaling it up to our monolith. And this is actually where we are running into a few challenges. First of all is the way Bazel, we compute the class path for the IDE is we're using aspects similar to IntelliJ, which actually is pretty neat because it allows you to really explore everything what your build is doing, and then you get a very precise idea of how the class path gonna need to look like. However, you need to run a full build every single time, and that makes it slow. And also imagine in a situation that's very common as development, and especially at scale with many developers, is that your source code is not always in a buildable state. You run into build issues, and then everything breaks down, right? And so this is one of the struggles that we have. The other one is, why is it not reusing local cache when I run the build from the IDE than on the command line, right? So there's these little nuances that are not making things very easy, because The way we have our build set up, or we have our developers trained, is that when they pull in sync, they also do a local build most of the time to have all the source code generated and have everything in good shape, and then they launch the IDE. Oh, and then it's building again. The third thing that is very challenging is the disconnect. Usually what you can do in VS Code is you open a folder and then you see everything in it. However, given that language support is essentially a headless Eclipse, what the language server is doing underneath, it's creating an Eclipse workspace. And Eclipse is like all of these other IDEs, IntelliJ as well. It wants to have projects. And in those projects, it wants to have specific source folders and class paths and everything specific in the structure. So you have to actually think how you map from the Bazel world into an IDE world. And this is where we actually think the structure is not flexible enough. So we have a couple of ideas, things that we want to do. And to some extent, this is not just a product pitch, what I'm doing a project pitch. So if you're interested into that as well, come talk to me afterwards. We are heavily looking into invest into this. One idea is we have is that in addition to aspects, we're going to investigate into several strategies, how we read the build files, either read them directly or query Bazel Graph as well to get an idea of how we can set up the projects. The custom build file handling is something that I'm going to talk about later in my other session this afternoon. We have a very strong convention for how our build files are written. So, and we learned that this is actually the fastest way. If the language support, the IDE can just analyze the build file, know exactly that based on the syntax of the build files, know exactly what the target is, what's doing, and then set up the class file right for you. So that's also an area that we're investigating. The other thing is, as I mentioned already, conventions. Bazel is great. You can do a lot of things in it, but it's not always the best idea when you're working with developers at scale. So we're also looking at things we can avoid. One example is split packages. A Java package, it's very easy to, in Bazel, it's very easy to have a single Bazel package which maps to a Java package and then produces two different Java files, which means you have a bunch of Java classes in that one and a bunch of Java classes in the other one, but they both share the same Java package. This is a terrible idea to do from a JVM perspective. We had a lot of problems back in the day with OSGI and even now with the Java module system. It's something you really like to avoid doing. So these are all the things that when you set up or pause this, right, which they look easy from a basic perspective, but how do you visualize that in an IDE? Right? The developer sees a folder and sees a bunch of Java files, and then he's writing his code, and then why doesn't it compile? Like they're in the same package, right? So there's a lot of things that still need to be addressed to make developer productivity in the IDE a pleasant experience to work with Bazel. And with that, thanks very much. And again, if you're interested in working with us on this, please reach out to me. Thank you.